Hi there. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use the gravitypdf download shortcode with the three different confirmation types Gravity Forms offers, the text, page, and redirect confirmation. So let's go take a look. I'm on one of my forms that I have a PDF configured on, and I'm currently on the confirmation settings page. I've got a default confirmation set up with just a standard message here, and I want to put the PDF download link right below this. So to do that, I need to go to the PDF page, and under the shortcode column, I can copy this shortcode here and paste it straight into the text confirmation. And that'll display a download PDF link that the user can click to download. Hit save. And then we head to front end website where the form is embedded. Fill out the form. I'm just going to enter a bunch of it. Information here so that we can see it in the PDF that we download. Okay, hit submit. That confirmation message, thanks for getting in touch. Well, thanks for contacting us. We'll get back to you and download PDF. And if I click that, it'll be a copy of the generated document that we've set up. This is the focus gravity template and it includes all the selected items. Now, you may not want a text link, you may want a button. And we can turn this into a button with CSS and a custom class name assigned to it. Your theme may have button styles already. I'm using 2020, I think. Let's have a look. Themes. Yeah, for this demo, I'm using 2020. It does come with button styles in the block editor. If I go add page, I just want to get a button on the screen, publish, so I can use the CSS class of this button with the gravitypdf shortcode. To do that, I need to open my browser development tools. Use Google if you're not sure how to do that. And I'm going to use the element selector and click my button. You see here this button has a class of wp-block-button __link. And that's what we'll copy into our shortcode so it can be styled much more like this button here. Just go ahead and copy that. And we'll head back to our confirmation. I'm going to add a new attribute called classes. You can take a look at our documentation for all the available attributes that you can use with the shortcode. Classes is one of them. I'm going to paste in that class we saw and hit save. And now if we go ahead and go back to our form and fill it out. I'll just enter some dummy data here. So we're not so much interested in the content of the PDF now as we are the download link. And you can see now we have this nice button here that matches the design of the theme. Now you could write your own CSS. You could just go into the customizer here, and under additional CSS, you could put your own button styles. Inline block. I did spell that right. Inline block. And you could publish that. And then you could use this class instead of the button link class. We save that confirmation now. Head back and fill in our form. Just some dummy data here. Again, submit. And we've got a different style for our button. Doesn't look that great, especially compared to the other button. But you can play around with the CSS to get it exactly how you want. And that's how you can change the look and feel of that download link button how you need it to. So going back to confirmations, now we'll do a page confirmation. And I'll copy this shortcode and go up to page. We don't need it when configuring that shortcode. We don't need it in the confirmation setup. We will need it when we add it to our confirmation page. So when I select pages, it's going to give me a drop-down list of all the pages under the pages section on our website. I'm going to leave it selected on confirmation page, which is a page I set up earlier. Now, the parse field data via query string. This is a really important one. Because this is an independent page on your website and it's not part of the Gravity Forms process, the shortcode that we embed doesn't know what entry it needs to generate a link for. So by passing the entry ID as a query string, it will allow that shortcode to work properly. So we're going to have entry for the name, and then we're going to set it to the entry ID merge tag. Now you can either type that out, or you can use the merge tag selector over here on the right, and right down the bottom, and scroll up a little bit, will be entry ID. We can click that and hit save. So once the confirmation's set up, we need to set up the page. We'll go to pages and click on our confirmation page. Now this is partially set up. We've got a thank you message and some text here. Now we need to embed the shortcode. Could use the shortcode block, but it doesn't give us much style options. I've actually centered all this text on the page, so I'm going to use the classic. Go back to the classic block for this, and I'll paste in my shortcode. And I want to center that on the page. I'm going to change the class back to our original theme class, which I've forgotten the name of. So we'll go back to pages, button styles, and there it is, wp-block-button. Underscore link. I might change the text too. I might change it to click here to download your PDF. Just for something different. Okay, if I view the page now, you actually won't see the button. And that's because in the address bar, you can't see at the moment, but in the address bar up the top here, the entry attribute isn't included. So nothing's going to show up. If we pass in a valid entry ID, that will generate correctly. So just this back up here, and we'll go ahead and submit a new form so you can see that in action. Smash the wrong shortcuts on my keyboard. Might wonder where I come up with these addresses. Just make them up. Something whimsical about just popping something in off the top of your head. We'll leave that. How can we help you box empty? Submit. And we've got thank you for your purchase. Use the buttons below. Click here to download your PDF. Now you can see that there's a bit of spacing there that you might need to adjust. I'd say that comes from the classic block. We click the button now, we'll have our PDF document. That's how you get a nice button on your confirmation page. Again, it's theme dependent and you'll need to tweak it here or there to get the exact results you want. But there's some options available to you. Now, the last confirmation type is the redirect. So I'm just going to go up to the forms menu item in the toolbar, and I'll go back to settings on our form, confirmations, change this to a redirect confirmation. We can delete the pass field data via query string now. We don't need that for the redirect. We're just going to paste in our short code here. Now, I think it's gonna paste in the email. We'll go back to the PDF page and we'll copy that short code again. Normally, you're not setting up three confirmations on the same form with the same PDF. So you would just enter the PDF list page once and copy that short code. We're going to hit save confirmation now as the redirect, and you can see that shortcode got updated a little bit and now includes the entry attribute and a raw attribute, which basically converts this this shortcode into a URL instead of a link or a button like you've seen, and that's the correct format that Gravity Forms needs to be able to redirect to the PDF. That's all you need to do for the redirect. You don't need to configure anything else. If we go back to our form now and fill it out for the last time, don't worry about the address this time, and hit submit. It's downloaded that PDF right away. With our info. And that's the various ways you can use the Gravity PDF download shortcode with the three available Gravity Form confirmations. Enjoy!